Hello everyone, welcome back to Mohana Astrology. Rajshri here with yet another video on transit as per Vedic astrology. Today I'm going to discuss about the transit of Mars in the sign of Taurus that's happening on 22nd of February 2021 and what will be the impact of that in our lives. After a long stay in its own sign of Aries, Mars is finally moving to the next sign, Taurus, on 22nd of February, and it's going to meet Rahu over there. Mars is going to be in Taurus along with Rahu till 14th of April 2021. We all know that Taurus is an earthy sign and its ruler Venus is a watery planet with feminine energy. Mars, on the other hand, is a fiery planet and it has masculine energy in it. So when Mars moves to Taurus, it has this Taurus sign has this impact on Mars, which kind of pacifies the impulsiveness of Mars. At the same time, it gives rise to some passionate outbursts as well. So this Mars is a practical Mars, but very headstrong. This Mars appreciates the good things in life and at the same time would like to accumulate wealth as well. Now, as Mars progresses through Taurus, it's coming closer and closer to Rahu, which is already sitting there. Now, on 28th of March 2021, Rahu and Mars are forming the exact conjunction at 20 degree of Taurus in the nakshatra of Rohini, which is ruled by Moon. And this conjunction is forming in the Cancer Navamsha. Now, while we are talking about Rahu, I would like to mention one thing here that in my Rahu Ketu transit video that I published in on 18th of August, 18th of August 2020, there I mentioned that Rahu's transit to Taurus and Ketu's transit to Scorpio is going to bring out some kind of hidden information about the universe and about the existence of aliens. Now, guess what? 3 days ago, there was a stunning news that Pentagon says, the news says that the Pentagon admitted to holding and testing wreckage from UFO crashes, confirming finding of an alien metal which can go back to its original shape even if it is deformed or destroyed. So I just find this completely amazing how accurate the predictions can go if you can actually read it correctly. Anyway, coming back to the Mars Rahu conjunction that's happening in February. And in our classics, this conjunction is termed as Angarak Yoga. Why is it called Angarak Yoga? That's because of the release of intense energy that forms due to combination of Rahu and Mars. Both are fiery signs and both have this fire elements in them. In one hand, Mars is the warrior, it's the adamant planet. It takes actions, do not think before taking actions. And on the other hand, Rahu is the master of deception. It can blow things out of proportion very quickly and very effectively. So when these two are coming together, it has the potential to, cause mass scale destruction or, some kind of disruption across the globe. Now, Venus, the ruler of Taurus, is combust during this entire transit, during this entire combination. So it's not able to provide a pacifying support to this conjunction. Now, what can we expect from this conjunction in general? In general, we can expect volcanic activities, earthquakes, fire-related accidents, some kind of, you know, bloodshed, tension with the border, because Rahu represents foreign countries. And there can be actually parasitic or viral diseases as well. Now the good news. The good news is, number one, Jupiter is aspecting this combination with its ninth aspect. And secondly, Rahu and Mars's dispositor Venus is going to its exalted sign of Pisces. And that's happening on 17th of March. So during the exact conjunction, these two benefic planets are kind of, you know, pacifying the intense energy of the conjunction. Now, Jupiter currently is pretty powerful, and on 28th of March, it will be at the last couple of degrees of Capricorn. It is not conjunct with any, you know, malefics. It is not combust. It has the Nichabhanga Raj Yoga supported by Saturn, and it is gracefully away from Saturn now. So there is a lot of positivity about this Jupiter. So when this Jupiter aspects this conjunction, we can expect that there will be some sort of prudence, there will be some sort of wisdom that will help to tackle this situation in a much effective way. There is one thing that we have to take into consideration, and that is during this close conjunction, Jupiter will be in the nakshatra of Dhanishta, which is ruled by Mars again. Now, who needs to be extra careful during this conjunction? I'm not going to discuss about, you know, what is going to happen ascendant wise. Because, you know, it's a very negative energy that's forming, and it has the impact to influence everyone's life in unfavorable ways. So I'm not getting into those details. What I'm doing here is kind of hinting at who needs to be a little more careful during this conjunction, and others should also exercise care and caution, because the entire energy is quite volatile. So we cannot really escape this energy. If you have Taurus, Cancer, Scorpio ascendant or moon sign, you should be careful. And if your moon or ascendant is placed in moon nakshatra or Mars nakshatra or Rahu nakshatras, you need to be careful as well. If you are running Mahadasha or Antardasha of Mars, Moon, Rahu or Venus, if you have this conjunction already present in your birth chart, that is Rahu-Mars conjunction is there in your birth chart, or if in your birth chart Rahu and Mars are in opposition, that is 180 degree from each other. So if you have these combinations, or if you have this kind of placements in your birth chart, please be a little more careful during this time. So let me conclude with this. And I'm sure if we are careful, cautious, and we are using our right wisdom, we should be able to, you know, sail through this combination, conjunction, very, you know, without too much of disturbance and disruption. The conjunctions, malefic conjunctions, negative conjunctions do keep on happening every now and then. We rarely do get to see something good is happening, honestly. So as we know, life is difficult. As we know, environment is difficult. We need to accept this. We need to work through this. And we need to just, you know, keep on doing our stuff till the time the disruptive energy goes away from our lives. And that is the way to live life as well. So long for now. I'll see you again with yet another video on Vedic astrology. Till then, may God bless us all. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please don't forget to subscribe and like this. Thank you.